Hello for Tuesday, January 8th, and on Monday, pretty good day again in the market. We had some nice movers. Not a lot, but they had good percentage gains. Dow had nice consolidation, stayed above the this top breakout line, 13,366. I mean, it went below it intraday. What was his low? 13,343, so a little bit below, but then it came right back up, closed over it. The volume was a little bit above, a little bit below the 60-day average in volume, but just what you want to see in consolidation. This is now the third day, so it's kind of like a little flag coming off this tall flagpole, so we could move up right from here and not have any big pullback. We'll look at the SPX, the same situation. Yesterday, as you know, on Friday, went up to the above the highs from October, and we had a little bit of a pullback also during the day, and moved down only 0.3% overall for the day. And you can see volume was lighter than last week, Friday, so that's also constructive when you have a consolidation day. You want lower volume if possible. Hardly anything happened at the end of the day on the Russell. Actually, it was 3 points, but compared to what has been moving, I mean, there has been times in the past where 3 points, that's $300 or a 50% gain if you're trading futures per you know, the money that you tie up. But after a big movement like this, I mean, up over 100 points from the buy in November. Anyway, a slight day, and it was down a little bit, but you can see very small candle, a tight range insofar as the day. It just was a gap down there and then a gap from the close, I mean. And so not much happening. We'll look at the futures on these quickly. There's not much to show really, but you can, because the range is so small, out of this little kind of like pennant or flag, there was a little drop here. This was the pivot point, was running there, and it did drop down, but then it just came right back up again. You know, there just wasn't enough volume to anyone wanted to sell it. Why? They missed the rally, so they'd want to stay in. Maybe, hopefully, they'll get some more of it. But obviously, you don't want to go below. I think if you start getting below the low of Monday, then you could sell off some more, maybe even down to this first gap. But I don't think it's likely right away. I think maybe it wouldn't happen. We'll see. It's going to want to try new highs. If it fails there, then be a little more cautious. But at the moment, I think that's more likely scenario, that it's going to try for the highs first. S&P 500, same situation. It was just, this isn't an important trend line. It's just from the one day, really, in the overnights. Here's the third. Here's the last week, then the third and the fourth and the seventh. So it dropped a little bit below this little line, but you can see it stayed above the low over here. So horizontally, and it just moved up. So really not terribly interesting. Same thing with TNA. That's the 3X ETF, and also natural gas. Just those, very little movement. In other words, not much to report on. So we've got the dollar. It dropped. You can see pulling back to perhaps the 50-day. So it may just find that and then just turn right back up from there. So this is, this is an area to be watched, because quite often you see that's this meaningful over here. It was the 50-day when it ran up. It couldn't get above, so it came back down. Over here, as it dropped, it opened right at the 50-day. That dropped. It came back up. Couldn't get above over here. So right now, that should be support. 80.28 is where it sits. Gold dropped further in the day. And we said gold is done, doesn't look that interesting. And at the moment, it looks like it's just going to continue lower for a while, maybe go back under this lower Bollinger Band. But we don't like to, when you look at a chart, the first thing you notice is all these red volume bars. We don't notice a lot of green ones going up. The red ones are basically taller in a visual real quick. GDX, maybe we shouldn't show the chart a lot because it's been so whipsaw, and we've been talking about that, that it's just likely to continue. Occasionally you get one spurt, and all of a sudden this goes on the long. Maybe one not to trade for a while until we get to some inflection point with gold, and you know, where a rig gets washed out and wants to move up, or there's some news reason why it should be moving. SOV continues. It was just down 6 cents. It continues as a short, but it hasn't had much movement as well. We discussed that in the market newsletter, which of course you can look at top right hand corner of StockTiger.net if you have not seen it already. Okay, remember on the earnings season starts. Here's a bunch of them. Mainly it's Alcoa. You know, they're the lead off right there. That always kicks off the earnings season. You can see there aren't many. There's just this one page here. So there's not a lot of stocks reporting, but it is the start, and there'll be a lot more in the following week. So be aware and check the earnings calendar. There's a link to the Yahoo one, or you can Google it in the newsletter always, but check those on overnight hold so you don't by accident hold one and then find out the report earnings and have a surprise to the downside. Some of the stocks from the watch list action on Monday, as we posted the Virgin Media in the morning, we said, well, it's moved up, but the volume was really wimpy. It just wasn't big at all. And you can see it moved up a little bit over this line. But when you're breaking over a trend, over kind of like a little flag or rebound, you really want strong volume on it. And or else you'd like to see at least a pullback down to support. If it'd beaten down in this area, it might be a buy just because that would be a good reversal. But from where it is, it could just be consolidation for a while, but still action. We just, it's just not re-triggered. Yes, triggered, but it was a big gap up. And you can see very heavy volume. I think there's some takeover news on it you can read about. But anyway, that's now off the list. It did the gap up 8% was a move on it. Now VVUS, this gapped as well. And so what we did is we posted the link to the 15-minute gap rule chart, and then we posted the chart, and you can see that as it turned out, here you have the first three candles, the way the gap rule, you know, you use a 5-minute chart, so you draw a line at the lowest range of the first 15 minutes, the first three bars, and at the highest range of the first three bars. And then you buy, if you want to, you buy on a break above the high. And some people even short it there if it can't break above. Or some people like to buy if it comes down to this support, the gap, and comes over. But basically, it keeps you out of a trade. In this case, it was good. It just kept you out. So you didn't, you know, if otherwise, you're just flying blind. Where are you going to buy? When are you going to sell? Here, you know exactly. If it breaks above, you put a stop there and you can just keep moving it up. And so you're going to lock in some profits, or you have a quick loss because your stop goes in below. Other thing, this is a 9-day, this is a 9-period, meaning because it's a 5-minute chart, a 9-period EMA. Sometimes that's useful to use. If you're in a trade already and it drops below it, that's caution. You might want to take your profits. Anyway, this one, as it turned out, was not a buy, even though it gapped up. But then we've got another one, which is PPHM. It was on the list a long time ago. Well, December, whenever, over the 145. Remember, it kind of hit it, and then back and forth, and then it hit it here, then dropped a couple of days. So anyway, big gap up. And, of course, this one ended up 80%. Not a bad move. Look at this volume, incredible volume, 62 million shares. But this one, on the other hand, using a 5-minute, the 15-minute gap. Here's the first opening 15 minutes right here. The, you know, the first 5-minute bar, and then two more bars, and a few more. So this is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 minutes. So 30 minutes after the open, that's when the buy came, as it broke over that first 15 minutes at about 190. And it ran up to 255. And right there, if you're using this 9-period EMA, right there may have been a time you took profit, unless you used it, you know, another area like down here. You might have shown this as support and you might have stayed in the trade. Then the next buy, if you're playing this, would have been on break above 253. And you can see it just got right to it. And that was right resistance where it pulled back. Anyway, so if you use the gap rule, you did really well on PPHM, and it was up 80%. Okay. On other stocks of interest, this is, remember how this went up 20%. This is on the watch list on Friday. It triggered. This was to buy on a break from this flag period here, or on the horizontal line. Either one of those. It ran up really big on Friday, and it stayed under the Bollinger Band, which was good. Now it closed over. So this one moved up another 12%. So you probably took some additional profits on that one as well during the day. Now, this one is not a watch list I'm going to show you, because it's interesting that it's a more than double. Last, I guess it was Tuesday, Someone just sent an email asking about this chart, and when I first looked at it, I didn't notice the price. I just noticed the structure looked kind of interesting with a big volume up here, and then I noticed the price, and I wrote back. I said, well, I don't really trade these, sub-penny or one-penny stocks like this, but I drew this little chart showing what it is in a triangle, and it did have a big volume going up, and now it's small volume. But I said, the volume's just too tiny for, even though it's a, one penny stock, 1.5 penny stock. But anyway, then the next day, then the next day, then a consolidation day, and then this day. So you can see it's more than doubled. But I'm just pointing it out. I didn't trade this one, but thanks for the pointer anyway. But these sub ones are tough because you got to buy so many shares if it's a 1 penny stock or 2 penny stock. But if you did it anyway, you're up 100% for the week. Good going. All right, let's get to additions to the watch list. They're not surprisingly all longs. Now, DXCM had good volume, not quite double its normal volume, but very good volume for it. It's normally low price, low under 500,000. It did 677,000. So it ran up as high as 1495. Here we have this 1448, 1450. I think a move back over that again. It'd be nice since it's run up now. This is 4 or 5 days. If it goes sideways first. If it goes sideways and then breaks over, it'd be better. If otherwise, it's going to put it back up over the top Bollinger Band, so you could use it as a trade. Maybe scalp it for 30 cents, 50 cents, or whatever it goes to. As it gets up high, watch the volume. If it starts slowing down in volume, but short-term wise, because you can see right here is where you're about 1525 is where you're getting back into some resistance area. Anyway, we add it to the list. We forgot that we have... This one was out of order. It's just showing that there's another one that triggered also on last week and also had a very nice continuation move. And this is what you like to see, this nice tall candles in green, the volume bars in green, and then the consolidation day was low on Friday. So it was ready to move again. It was under the Bollinger Bands as well. Another addition is Fuel Cell, FCEL. This is also a low price stock. And remember, these low priced ones, it's still in the time when the Russell's doing good. So a lot of the small caps can run pretty well. So it's hard to say. It's a continuation from here. And low price ones are risky. Just pointing out that the volume looks pretty good. It may continue a movement over this 106. And then we've got like 109. And from there, maybe even 18. Maybe I'll try that again. But just pointing it out to you because I say the low price ones have been doing some interesting things. FRAN back over about this 28 with the first movement possible up to 29 or 2970 is where it was before. So this could be an okay move. Looks all right. The volume increased a little bit on Monday, so maybe this will continue as well. Next up is HALO. It ran into its 200 day. It ran into it again. Then it dipped down, then it ran up to it again, and now it's closed over the 200-day, which is good. So if it can break over the 719, especially maybe if it does that, people get noticed it, and the volume will come in even stronger because that's what you want to see, good volume on a breakout. But closing over the 200-day is, of course, a good sign. Now, MCP, Molly Corp, we had this on the list not long ago, and it's done pretty well, and then it came off down here into a, went down for quite a while, broke out of there on a gap, came down to its 200-day. It's moving back up again. This might be just a quick little trade from these two areas just to begin with. So we're just putting it down as a situation over 1175, but the volume is suggesting it wants to go higher. So that's the first area to try to 1175 with the first move just over 1250 possibility. PBI over 1170. Pitney Bowes needs some more volume, but it has closed over the 50-day, and that's the first time since in October when it came crashing through both the 50-day and 20-day. And over here, we did come back over the 20-day, and just on Monday came over the 50-day as well. And you can see the Williams has recently crossed up. So this could start. The first movement is to here, then see how it goes. If it consolidates, maybe it'll go back up eventually to the 200-day EMA. And then we have VOLC over about 2436. The first logical target after crashing through the top Bollinger Band would be the 2535. This is close to the gap over here. So let's see if we have increased volume over 2535. 24.36. So that's what we have for Tuesday. Hope you have a great day trading. Thanks a lot for watching. We will send tweets out before the market opens and during the day as well as things develop. So do pay attention to those. Otherwise, have a super day. We'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas in Market Wrap.